don't take no kids playing 249. I just want to remind everybody we're having a meeting tonight down at the meeting town. We're going to talk about taking shit across down by Hall Shooter Creek. They've been taking up more than their share of the land down there. Ain't going to leave nothing for the wild game to live in. And come this fall, there ain't going to be nothing to kill. The sport's going to be gone. So I want everybody to show up tonight so we can plan what we're going to say. And I think they're going to live. This is going to lock things off. There's no KKK for Plan 249. Thank you.
This is Petey Fitz speaking to you from the Greater Tuna Humane Society. And I'd like to ask each one of you to take a minute and think about ducks. It's tough being a duck. Cartoons portray ducks as genetic mutants with speech impediments. And in fact, the very word duck we use as a verb means to rapidly lower body position to avoid injury. So when you say the word duck to somebody, they don't know if you're talking about a bird or an accident. And the Chinese eat their feet too. Now you may not know, but we have a duck crisis situation right here in Tuna. Ever since the government flooded Buckner Basin, the ducks have had no nesting ground to lay. We've been up to our nesting home with ducks. To remedy this situation, the Humane Society has published a pamphlet, Duck Trapping Without Trauma, and will deliver copies to every home in the area. So if you find a trapped duck, give it to me, TV Fitz, and I'll personally relocate them in unflooded areas. This is TV Fitz speaking to you from the Greater Tuna Humane Society. Thank you. the radio station OKKK, where every day we take a few minutes just to find out what's up Tuna's Cross. I see the phone lines are all lit and up, and we'll take our first lit it up call after we take a quick look at this week in Tuna. I got a message here from the Reverend Spackers over at the Cowee Baptist Church. He said he's sponsoring another record burner. He said to bring all your rock and roll. Be sure leave this time to get your little Richard, your friend, to leave the Chuck Berry. He said to leave that Buddy Holly Nelson at home. They're good Southern boys, and they'll be forgiven. Anyway, that'll be coming to you this Sunday night at 8 o'clock over at Cowee Baptist Church. Let's see what else we got here. Oh! Ida Thompson sponsored another trip to the Eureka Springs Passion Play over in Arkansas. She says that if you signed up, she's leaving at 7:45 a.m. from the First Methodist parking lot. She says if you're not there by 7:45, she's going to leave you. Okay, let's take our first lady out caller. Hello, you're on the line with Leonard.
Stanley,
Phineas Glide's a model citizen. Dogs in your neighborhood are subjected to. Sincerely.
Woo! Roscoe, is that you? My goodness.
The buzzer went off. They say Maxine threw a wall that fit, and she's still in the hospital recovering from shock. But we talked to her chaperone, Mildred D. Perkins, and she said that Maxine will be back for that swimsuit competition come tomorrow night. That girl's a real trooper.
She is.
She is, she is, she is. And from our national news desk, nuclear accident imperils millions in 7 states. Texas, not blue.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's all the news we got for you, but don't touch that dial.
Don't touch that dial. Get away from it.
Get away from us. Tuna Speaks is next. This is Petey Fist speaking to you from the Greater Tuna and Humane Society. You know, we receive a whole lot of flack here at the Humane Society, saying that we're insensitive to the needs of fish. Now, this is not true. We care a great deal about fish. We understand that when you take a fish out of the water with a hook in its mouth, take a knife and stick it up its anal opening, scrape its insides out, cut up its neck, that fish feels that. River and streams.
He was the cream in Tuna's coffee. He fought fire with fire and kept the whole fires burning. When he couldn't stand the heat, he got out of here. He would walk that extra mile and he would walk it snowing.
Getting arrested. Because my mom's got diabetes and I carry this meat around in case she is sick. Thank you, nothing I need but air, Sheriff. Nothing but air. Anything wrong with having a hypodermic needle full of air, Sheriff? Is that against the law?
You think you're real smart, don't you, Jimmy? You think you're real smart.
Well, I got a witness. That's right, you, Miller. I got a witness.
No, you're not too smart. No, I wouldn't say so. Not so smart. No, I wouldn't say so.
Well, are you going to charge me with anything?
Yeah, I'm going to charge your ass. You made me think we're like stupid old car boys. We can keep an eye on you.
All right, you can charge me, do it.
I'm going to charge you. There you go, Emily. Traffic tickets, two of them. One for speeding 40 and a 20 zone, and another for